Hello. In this video, we will take a look at how to build a plan in Hansoft. And I'm going to use a project here called Game One. So the plan I'm going to build will be for a small video game to get started with that. And I will obviously be in the planning view in Hansoft. That's where you will do most of your planning. So navigate to your project and click on planning. And I am also a main manager in this project. So that will help you a lot if you want to follow along with what I'm doing here. So we want to build a plan, and there will all be a lot of unknowns, as there always are in projects. So we need to start to figure things out here. So I prefer to divide the plan into two sections, and I'm going to do that using something called the subproject in Hansoft. So first I'm going to have a subproject, which would be my sort of high level plan. And in this case, it's going to be my releases primarily. So what are the big important times we will deliver software? And now we're looking at a game here. So there will be a vertical slice coming up first, maybe. We will have a new release later on. There will be a alpha version. Then we're going to have a beta version. We are going to then maybe have a first submission candidate. On top of that, it might also be that we want to do, for example, an E3 demo. So that's maybe be a highlight here. So I'm going to change the color of that one to red here. And you'll notice that when I'm creating these, they will always be listed out on today's date automatically here. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit. And then, you know, some of these things are going to happen much later. So this is going to be fixed in Q2 sometime next year, maybe. And we're going to have a first submission candidate. It's going to happen a little bit later. We're going to have a beta available a few months before that. And then we hope to have the alpha ready sometime around the same time we're doing the demo. But the vertical slice, that needs to be done sometime already by the end of this year, for example. So that's the first part, just listing out a little bit of what the longer term looks like and what are the important dates that we need to sort of plan our ways backwards from to understand our total scope that we could fit into the game based on what we know today. That will change, of course, as we learn more. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, come back to today's date here. I'm going to add another subproject. I could also right click and add it right here. And I will call this one sprints, because this is where I'm going to put my sprints, which are going to be a way for me and this team to do short iterations of work, 2 weeks probably at a time, where we try to make as much progress as possible and where we have a time to have a retrospective after each one and review what have we done, how can we improve, and so forth. So in projects with a lot of unknowns, that's a great way of getting started with planning in Hansoft. And I should note that if you don't see the new sprint option here on your toolbar, it's probably because it doesn't say agile schedule here. So then you click here and you switch to agile schedule, as will be the option that you will see. The other alternative, if you don't see it, is that you simply don't have permission to. So you're not the main manager in this project. So right now, only main managers will be allowed to edit this before you have delegated something out to some other users. All right, so, but I hit new sprint. It gave me this bucket called no name. So I'm gonna rename it to sprint one. I like to write a goal for this sprint. So this might be our MVP, or not even MVP, might be something early prototyping or something like this that we should call this instead. Like that. And then what we wanna do is that we want to look over the team that's gonna work in this project. So in this case, this is automatically set to the members of the project. If you want to change this, add people or remove people, you can click here to allocate users to this sprint. And I'm fine with having the four people here. But what I want to do, though, is to make sure that we don't work 80 hours or schedule 80 hours in the next 2 weeks. For sure, people will work that amount of time, but we don't want to schedule people 100% of their time, because there are always reasons. And that will cause a lot of troubles, you know, unexpected work that's come in, which means that you're going to run into issues if you do 80 hours. So two things you want to do. First one is to go to more, customize project, agile and scheduling. No, sorry, calendar. And then you want to set the place we're in. In this case, you'll see that I have set this project. Everyone is in Finland. You can also reduce the working hours if you want to here. But I'm usually not just setting up the calendar here, especially if everyone in the team is in the same location. So in this case, we see that there are no holidays that are impacting this sprint. If there would be a holiday, let's see when the next one is, it will look something like this. So here's the next holiday here, an Independence Day on December 6th. The next thing we'll do is to start looking at each individual person. So developer David, maybe 80% is a common kind of allocation percentage. Example, project manager, very busy with other things, not have that much time. Executive Esther, maybe the same thing, is running around looking for funding everywhere. And then tester Tina is maybe also 80% of her time available here. So we're now down to roughly 160 hours of available capacity in the next 2 weeks. Of course, these people have different skills and you know, capabilities in what they can do. Though in small projects, it tends to be that everyone is wearing many hats, but right now we just have a rough understanding of, okay, where are we at in terms of how much work we can put on this team and on each individual. So now we have locked in our time, we have locked in our cost here for the next 2 weeks. And then what we will be working with primarily now when we're building out the plan is that we will be working with the sprint backlog. So the sprint backlog have different sources of work. So one of them could be that I just want to take a new sprint backlog item here. And I want to say that we're going to do a Hansoft training, for example. We are going to be, I'm going to see here so we can see the columns. I'm going to assign everyone in the team to take this training, and everyone will spend maybe 4 hours on this. So now we're laying out 4 hours here. You can see, depending on people's percentage, we have different length of the bar here. So this is just work that's happening as a part of the team building, so to say. And then we might have things coming in from the product backlog itself. So I'm opening up the product backlog view. I'm going to move this to the side now so we can see the backlog side by side with the plan. And let's see, let's take some of the build pipeline improvements here. Let's take those two. So I'm going to drag and drop those into my planning view. You could also just right click, or there will be a column to set. I want to commit this work to a sprint as well. This little green arrow next to the item indicates that it has been committed from a sprint. So now we can start breaking these down into tasks. So I can either do like this. I say this is task one, this is task two, this is task three. And I'm using keyboard shortcuts here. It's the same thing as using breakdown here and new sprint backlog item. You can hit Control Shift N for breakdown and Control N to create a new task. I can break things down to as many levels as I would like. That's not a problem. I'm going to undo here now using Control Z back to task three. And then we might give this some estimates. So let's say they're all going to take roughly 20 hours each. You'll see now how there's one new bar here saying not assigned to member of sprint that's showing up. So saying that even if I haven't assigned this to anyone, we will start seeing these bars filling up. So I'm not over allocating on the total sort of team level. And a team may have two different ways of working here. One is that people kind of pick up work as they go. And the other one is that you pre-assign during your sprint planning and say, well, David is going to work on this. We're going to have Tester Tina work on this. And then we're going to have Executive Esther working on this, for example. And now we triggered a little bit of a problem for ourselves, that Executive Esther now have 24 hours of work in the sprint, which is going to be a little bit too much based on her capacity. So we'll both get notified to task three. You're probably going to spill over. And Executive Esther is the person where it's going to spill over for. Maybe this is an approval task or something similar, where we can say, well, actually, we can assign this to example project manager. Okay, same thing. Well, then maybe we need to break this down into task 3A and task 3B, and then say, you know, we're going to split it up half-half, and then we're going to assign that out to Executive Esther and example project manager. Something like that. So that's one way of building out your plan, taking things from the backlog, creating them here, breaking them down further, or take things from the quality assurance section if you want to plan for bugs and things like that. In here as well, you can do that. Another way of doing this is to assign a pipeline. So if you're working with, for example, a definition of done, it's a great way to go into more pipelines and workflows and create a pipeline called definition done. So that could be, you can build this up in many ways, but this is like a predefined way of breaking down your work, you could say. So it could be that first we're gonna do some concept about this, then we're gonna code, then we're gonna have a code review in Helix Swarm, for example. Then we could work on some documentation here at the same time, after we've done the concept. And then we might go to QA, and you'll see I'm just adding these tasks and dragging arrows between them as we go. And then maybe we have a final approval. Something like this, you get the idea. This can look any way you want to. And the whole purpose of this is that you're gonna reach some sort of done state by the end of this. So I'm saving that, closing this. And then now what I can do is that I can say, okay, let's say for this basic 3D animation tools, I'm gonna have a column here called pipeline workflow. If you don't see this, you just right click, customize your columns and activate this one here. And then I'm gonna select that I wanna use my definition of done. And now that will pre-break it down for me. And I could also have configured the work remaining and assignees and things in that pipeline already if I wanted to. In this case, I'm just gonna do like this. I typically would recommend that you try to keep tasks, you know, somewhere between half a day and a couple of days, not too small and not too big. But there should be reason for people to go in to Hansoft at least once every day. So let's do some assignments here. And actually to speed this up, I'm just gonna assign all of this to Tester Tina using the batch edit window here at the bottom of the screen. We call that the item details. Okay, so now we have a plan, and you can see it's already quite a lot of information. We have a good understanding of what we're gonna do. And we could, if we wanna take this one step further now, we start connecting the work here with the work up here. So if I say, okay, these are things we need to do for the vertical slice, then I'm gonna tag this to the vertical slice release, and that's gonna now start showing up here. This might also be part of the vertical slice, but it might be that the Hansoft training has nothing to do with any of these specific releases. We don't have to tag it to that. You could also tag to multiple releases if you want to, and there are many options there of, you know, overriding things further down and so forth if you want to. The whole benefit with this now is that as this gets started, we're both going to get a burn down here for the sprint. But we will also be able to use this in reports and start seeing things like a burn down for the release itself, both in this planning view, and it's also possible to set up in dashboards. So now we both have progress, how we're doing in the short term, as well as how are we doing towards the longer term goal. The last thing I want to touch upon is that very often you might have within the sprint now the need to set priorities. So the way we'll do that, you can both set the sprint priority directly from here, but I could also go into the priority view, sprint priority view. And that allows me to both just see the things that are in this sprint backlog. And then I can set priorities on, okay, the Hansoft training, obviously top priority, basic animation tools is maybe medium. And then the things that are in this build pipeline improvements are potentially a little bit lower priority. You'll note this here, if I put this one to high priority or very high, for example, how it's gonna jump up and down. So this is very good for stack ranking things, of moving things between here. So this is gonna be very useful for me when I come into my to-do list. I will talk about another time that I will see things in the order we have set these priorities. So now I'm gonna change back to where we were before in the Agile schedule. And you'll see how the priorities have been set here as well. So the benefit now with what we've done is that we have both created the longer term plan and the shorter term plan. and we are on a good way to get started with this project. And then once we have finished this sprint, we're probably in a really good place to optimize, especially the longer term plan more, and then be ready to take the next step. So select the sprint, new sprint, and I will have a sprint 2 up here, ready to go. But we'll take the next step toward completing this amazing game we're gonna build. Thank you very much for watching this video, and please let us know if you have any questions.